We started this brand just 5 months ago. You know, during the pandemic, and wala, parang it all started with Provinciano. We had to enter the bubble, and so I had to make sure. Yeah, I had to make sure that my things were, you know, organized. Uh-huh. And I had to make sure that my things were labeled. My bags were labeled with my initials, SGM, just to make sure walang mawawala.
Right.
Because we weren't allowed plus ones and mga assistants nung first few rounds, because they were very strict with the people inside the bubble due to the virus. So when I looked at the bags that I had custom made, sabi ko dun sa friend ko, who's my childhood friend. I've been friends with her since I was, I don't know, first year high school.
Okay.
So I told her, but hindi na natin gawin business to. And so that's how it started. So that's how it started. We had boots made, bags made. But this expansion, we did not see this coming. So 5 months after, we are now turning into a lifestyle brand.
Uh-huh.
So the clothes that I'm wearing now is ours.
Wow, that looks... I thought that was like a signature brand from somewhere.
No! Well, it's locally made, locally sourced, and locally designed. So people always ask me what I'm wearing, who I'm wearing. And so somehow this brand is an extension of who I really am, I guess. It's my being OC. Like, I have to have my things always organized. Also, I'm sigura after so many years of being in the industry, I already know that I am not a trendy person. Mm-hmm. Like, trends come and go. Mm-hmm. So I look for classic pieces and like with good quality, and with my partner, who I call our quality control queen.
Yeah.
Siya yung she makes sure na maayos yung tahe, maganda yung tela. Yun, hindi kami mapapahiya. And so now we are officially a lifestyle brand, and we just don't make bags now. So bags are made of canvas, and then our clothes are made of linen, and who knows, we can do something with cotton maybe in the future. And but really, it wasn't planned. We put up this brand and with the intention of, you know, giving opportunities to people who wanted to work for us in the midst of the pandemic. But voila, we're growing now, and so many opportunities are coming our way. So, yun.
That is really exciting. Shaina, sabi mo na it started with just being OC, you know? Would you say that you're also OC with your life? Do you compartmentalize aspects of your life too?
Very much. I used to be a control... You mean life itself?
Yes.
Not just my things, okay? Yes. My things, okay lang na maging sobrang OC ako. But life itself, I used to be a control freak, and now I've just learned to let go and just, you know, be in the present moment, because there's really no use in holding on to the past and worrying so much about the future. Although I work on that still, diba? Parang sometimes, who doesn't? Diba? At one point, talagang parang, okay, so what's going to happen in the future? Is this going to be like this and that? And then you worry too much.
Mm-hmm.
So now, parang mas relaxed na ako ngayon with my life. I've learned to let go and just really treasure the now, the present moment. And so I don't take things for granted anymore. I don't even take people for granted anymore. Kasi parang pagka you're 2 steps ahead or like 5 steps ahead, paano naman yung mga taong kasama mo in this season of your life? And so now I just really wanna appreciate every single person that's, you know, in my life. And I don't have much anymore, because like what I've filtered well, but I have quality people in my life, and that brings me so much joy and peace. Of, you know, people that I can depend on and trust.
I hear you. Thank you for saying that, Shaina. That's a good reminder, actually. And panghuli na lang, Shaina, to anyone watching, who have a lingering idea about a business that they want to pursue or something that they mm-hmm. want to start, what advice can you give them to pursue it, to make that big jump?
Business, anyone can put up a business, but you know, to stay in the business, that's going to be the challenge, your sustainability. Also, even show business, diba? How are you going to stay in this business? You just have to love what you do, or else you'll get tired. Day one palang pagod ka na if you don't like what you're doing. I've been in that situation where I had no choice, and it was always a burden. That's why maybe I wanted to quit, kasi parang no choice. I had to do this and that and this and that. So as long as you love what you're doing, then you won't get tired of it. And also in every business, you have to be hands-on. And so, which brings me back to, you have to love what it is, whatever it is that you're going to sell or you're going to wear, or whatever it is that you're going to produce. And maybe at the end of the day, it has to be something bigger than you. Like one of our intentions with this brand is really to be able to help other people in the midst of the pandemic, give them jobs also. And who knows if we get to evolve into a bigger brand, then we'll be giving more opportunities to Filipinos, because we are really advocating locally made products and locally designed and locally sourced products. So it has to be bigger than you, and it has to serve a purpose.
And we are looking forward, Shaina, to organize Chica's lifestyle becoming
thank you. And
bigger. Shaina, thank you so much for your time, and thank you for being so open and generous.
Thank you, Miguel.